Our next player is the embodiment of international hockey. It's as if he were engineered to showcase the best defensive attributes from around the world. The smooth skating, heady style from his native Sweden, the gritty defense-first North American ethic, the dynamic best defense is a transition to offense approach of the Russians. He was the synthesis of all of these, making him one of the most complete players to play the game anywhere. The prototype defending machine, Nicklas Lidstrom, will never be replicated.
The art of playing defense is the art of attack and counterattack. To stop your opponent's charge and instantly launch a charge of your own. Nicklas Lidstrom was a master, and we have that on good authority. Nicklas Lidstrom joined the Detroit Red Wings as a rookie in 1991. His first defense partner, Brad McCrimmon, told him that being a pro means you show up for work every single day. Lidstrom took that advice to heart. He showed up all right, and how.
Lidstrom scores!
Nicklas Lidstrom played 1,827 regular season and playoff games. What is more impressive, he only missed 46 games in that span. No wonder his Red Wing teammates took to calling him Mr. Perfect. He was named the Norris Trophy winner as the NHL's best defenseman seven times. His 1,142 points is sixth all-time among NHL defensemen. Lidstrom won gold representing Sweden at the 1991 World Championships. Then in 2006, he helped Sweden achieve another golden moment on the world's biggest stage.
The shot scorer! What a rocket! Came off the stick gun, Nicklas Lidstrom!
Nicklas Lidstrom is a man of few words. He let his actions speak for him. His ability to be not only excellent, but consistently so for two decades, sees him take his rightful place in the Hockey Hall of Fame.
Here to present Nick with his plaque is 2009 Hockey Hall of Fame inductee Steve Yzerman.
A great captain. Thank you, and thank you, Steve, for presenting my plaque. I'd like to thank John Davison, Jim Gregory, and the rest of the selection committee for this great honor. It didn't hurt that Scotty and Igor and Luke were on the committee, so special thanks to them as well. I'd also like to thank Kelly and the entire Hockey Hall of Fame staff for all their work in making this a special weekend for my entire family. It's been a great weekend that we'll never forget. I'd like to congratulate the other inductees, Bill, Peter, Phil, Chris, Angela, and of course my old teammate, Sergey. It's an honor to be joining all of you in the class of 2015. And thank you, Sergey, we didn't have to share a room this time, like we did back in the 90s. There's an old saying in Sweden, det blir aldrig som man tänkt sig. In English, it would translate to, things never turn out the way you imagined. It's a very true statement for me. Because I grew up, like most kids, shooting pucks in my backyard or at the local rink, dreaming of scoring the big goal and winning championships. But for all the dreams I had playing hockey as a child, I never imagined a night like this. As kids who learn and fall in love with the game, all the way through being a professional, you play with one thing in mind, to win. Win the medal, the cup, the series, the game, the battles in the corners and in front of the net, the face-off. Although I didn't actually take any face-offs. But every night, you try your best to win. But you can't win this. You can't win the Hall of Fame. It's an honor that you have no control over, and that would never have imagined as a kid shooting pucks in the driveway. And because you can't win this night, it feels a little uncomfortable being up here alone. I certainly didn't get here by myself. It takes a team in all aspects of your life. Being a professional hockey player, you need people to teach you, to lead you, to make you better, to make you the best you can be. And I've had some of the greatest teammates, friends, and family right here with me at every step of my career. Too many to thank tonight, but I'm going to try my best and mention as many as possible in the time I have. It's hard to believe that it's been 24 years since I first walked into Joe Louis Arena. Even then, I wasn't alone. My agent, Don Amino, was there with me, and we were there to sign my first contract. I was 21 years old and 4,000 miles from home, and I knew very little about the Red Wings. So little that I first asked to wear number 9. It's one of the great things about hockey that if you make a mistake, there's always someone there to point it out to you. In this case, the equipment manager set the rookie straight, and I got my first lesson in Red Wings history. The player in person I was that day in 91 was nowhere near the same as when I became captain of the Red Wings in 2006. I had a lot of learning to do, both on and off the ice, learning what it meant to be a pro, learning how to lead, learning what it takes to win, and I learned that from Steve Yzerman. His dedication and will was at a level I had never seen before. The lessons I learned from Steve are some of the biggest reasons why I was successful. It was both an honor and a tremendous responsibility to be the captain that followed Steve, and I did my best to carry on that tradition and culture that he built. One of the most important parts of any team's success is to have owners who are committed to winning. And I can't imagine having better owners than Mr. and Mrs. Illich. Their commitment allowed me to be a part of 4 Stanley Cup championships. And just as important, they really cared about me and my family. They made us all a part of their family. They not only made winning possible, they made it even more special. Brian Murray was my first coach in the NHL. He helped get me in the door, giving me the opportunity to play over here. And I'm very thankful for what Brian did for me early on in my career. Scotty Bowman came in and he took my game to another level. He gave me the confidence by playing me a lot and really pushed me to become a better player. Alongside Scotty, Dave Lewis and Barry Smith were very important to my career. Lewis was my assistant coach my first 13 years and he taught me how to play defense in the NHL. Mike Babcock came in along with Todd McClellan, Paul McLean and later Brad McCrimmon. It was later in my career, I was 36 and wanted to continue to play at the high level. And suddenly, I was the captain that everyone else looked to. The Babs helped me to become a leader on this team, and he pushed me to stay at the level where I wanted to be. Every night, he relied on me and put me out there in situations that I had a chance to succeed in, and I'm very grateful for that. I'd like to thank Ken Holland, Jim Neal, Jimmy DeValano, and Ryan Martin for their support over the years, always putting competitive teams together, no matter what the situation, and always striving to win another Stanley Cup, even if we had just finished winning one. I played with some great teammates over the years. They became great friends as well, and I missed the days of simply hanging out in the locker room with the guys. Together, we were able to accomplish some amazing things. Players like Chris Osgood, Chris Draper, Darren McCarty, Kurt Maltby, Matthew Schneider, Robert Lang, Henrik Zetterberg, Nicklas Cronwall, Pavel Datsyuk, and of course, my good friend, Thomas Holmstrom. There's another group of teammates and staff that I'm honored to join tonight. Those are the men who are in the Hall of Fame and that I had the honor and good fortune to play alongside. It really is an amazing group of teammates. Mike Modano, Dominic Hasek, Brendan Shanahan, Chris Chelios, Mark Howe, Dino Cicerelli, Steve Yzerman, Luke Robitaille, Brett Hull, Igor Larionov, Larry Murphy, Paul Coffey, Slava Fetisov, Sergei Fedorov, and off the ice, Scotty Bowman, Jimmy DeLano, and Mike Illich. After tonight, there will be 12 people in the Hall of Fame from that 2002 Red Wings team, and we might add a couple more in the years to come. All of that simply goes to prove that this truly is a team sport, and my success is really our success. I would also like to thank the Swedish Ice Hockey Federation and Team Sweden for the privilege to represent my country, something that I'm very proud of. I'm very thankful to have my family here tonight from Sweden. My parents were always there for me, driving me to different rinks, cheering me on and supporting me throughout my career. I have 3 sisters, so I'm sure my dad was pretty happy that I picked hockey. And I'm very thankful and fortunate to have my 4 sons and my wife Annika with me tonight, Now that I'm retired, I'm really enjoying spending time at home and coaching a little hockey with Kevin, Adam, Samuel, and Lucas. And I've come to appreciate all that Annika has done as a wife and mother. She possesses equal parts of love and patience, and she needs every bit of that, as she's the only woman in a house with four. Well, let's make that five boys. I certainly wouldn't be up here without her. Whether you were there for me to buy my first pair of skates and drive me to practice, or to help me sign my first contract, or sharpen my skates, or treat my injuries, or show confidence in me on the ice, or look back at me from the face-off dot and winked, or cheered for me from Detroit or Sweden, or were waiting for me after the game, win or lose, by my side. Thank you for taking something that even as a child I could never have imagined, and make it a reality in a night like this. I could not have done this without you, and I'm proud to share this honor with all of you. So, thank you.